Welcome to the tutorial for doing Elsa's smock top underneath her corset. I am going to refer to it as a smock top because I have no idea what else to call it. But basically I've got this quick sew pattern, 2932. It ranges from extra small to extra large. And I was thinking more like this one here. But what I really wanted to end up with is more of a raglan sleeve rather than a satin sleeve. And I'll be using a stretch fabric for this. So, these were the original pieces that came with it. So, you've got your back there. And this was your sleeve. As you can see, it looks like an average sleeve pattern. After doing a mock-up out of the original pattern pieces, it then had to be altered to make way for the raglan style sleeve, which is a sleeve that extends from the neckline, if you're wondering what that means. So basically we had to chop this strap affair out where the original sleeve would have gone into. So it's gone from looking like that to like this. I still basically kept the shape down here the same, except I made it longer. You don't have to curve it around, you can straighten and level off if you want to because it won't be seen, but that's just what I've chose to do. Obviously you can't alter that because that's your centre fold line, so that has to stay the same. So basically the only alteration was doing the mock-up, having somebody redraw the new line on your top for you, and recutting pattern pieces and then doing another mock-up just to make sure that it's all going to work out. And the same with the back again before it came in and curved it quite steep. So we only needed it to go here really, not quite up to your the top of your shoulder. And brought that line down from here like so. And again the rest was stayed the same. The sleeve then changes shape from this normal sleeve pattern that you see here to a straight edge, because the smock top has a straight edge all the way around. That only because it's made out of the stretch fabric will it give some kind of curve when you're actually wearing it, so it no longer lies as straight once it's made up. But basically you need to start off with a straight edge to go around the whole thing. And then the line extends out here to here. And I've actually, because the sleeve was too wide and too baggy, I've had to bring it in a bit more and then of course do the point that Elsa has on the end of her sleeve towards her hand. Right, for my Elsa top, I'm using this light blue stretch cotton jersey fabric. I chose this because it's a little bit thicker than the mesh idea, and I just wanted to stay a little bit warmer, just a little bit. Anyway, I bought it from this place, World Fabrics 2010 on eBay, $4.99 a metre. Okay, I've cut out my pieces. And so far they've just been sewn down there and there on both sides, and the top edge of the top has been turned over, so that just leaves the sleeve sides opening and the sides of the top still open. Also the pattern for where the crystals are going to go has been marked. I recommend that you try this on and have somebody mark it for you, because it's quite tricky to do by yourself. Now I'm using Swarovski crystals to decorate my top in crystal blue shade. Now I'm using two sizes. These are 3.2 SS12, and I will also be using a slightly bigger crystal 4mm SS16 as well. So I've got two sizes, both in crystal blue shade. And I've gone for hotfix. But if you don't want a hotfix or you don't have a tool, you can just glue them on with fabric glue. I've just finished decorating the top edge of the top, and I've gone for two rows of crystals in size 4mm, for one being the SX16. Okay, I've moved on since and decorated the tops of the sleeves round to the back and the front, and I've done both sides. I've decided to go for 4mm across the top, and I've started off by doing ones, and I've gradually built it up, and I've spaced it out because I've tried to have a look at the photos, and it seems like there's sort of there's patches, crystals sort of spaced out where there's glitter, and then there's pieces where there isn't. So that's what I decided to do. And then for the two thin rows in between, I use a size 3mm, and then I've gone back to 4mm here, like so. Next I'm going to be working on, as you can see, it's already been helped with doing my pattern. I originally did another. Okay, now I've finished decorating the top, and we've sewn up the side seams on the sleeve and down the side here. There are approximately 2,729 crystals on this top. I've decided not to go too crazy, otherwise you might start losing the pattern, and I think the idea is sort of the pattern has to stand out. So I thought if I just did too many lines, then it would not end up looking like it should do. I've used various sizes. Here I've got the 4mm, these are the 3mm, and then in the middle of the diamonds here, they're 1.8mm, so really tiny. I've decided to put some down the bottom of the sleeve as well, because I thought that looked quite nice. And the next thing to do will be just be to turn the bottom of the shirt under, hem that up, and then it'll be finished. This took about a week to decorate, just working on it a few hours at a time, a couple of hours here and there, but here we go.